Binder and ABC Audio present The Removalists, written by David Williamson. This is an ABC radio play and is read by a full cast including Patrick Phillips, Richard Meikle, Jane Harders, Marcelle Schmitz, Stephen Bisley and John Howard.
Melbourne, 1970. A small, inner suburban police station built fairly recently, but already having an air of decrepit inefficiency.
Morning. Constable Ross reporting for duty, Sarge.
Sergeant Simmons lounges at a battered old desk from which he surveys Constable Ross as if he were auditioning him for a crucial role in some play.
Well, what would you like me to do, Sarge?
For a start, you can stop bouncing up and down on your bloody toes. Do you think they'll stop your paycheck if you're caught standing still?
Oh, the pay's not too bad these days, is it?
Now, the money is not good, Ross. The money could be good if you happen to be in the right places, but this isn't one of them. No payoffs here, boy. A few perks, but no payoffs.
A recruit under 21 gets full adult pay these days. Do you know that?
How old are you, Ross?
20.
Money's not important, boy.
Well, you got to consider it.
You got to consider your arsehole, too. And what's your old man do for a crust?
My old man?
Well, is he still alive?
Yeah.
Well, what's he do?
Why did you want to know?
Oh, God. He must be a nightman or something. Slinging shit.
He's a carpenter.
Well, what's wrong with that? Christ was a carpenter. You shouldn't be ashamed of your old man because he's a carpenter.
I'm not ashamed of him.
No? I thought I noticed a little bit of hesitancy in your voice, boy. I thought it sounded as if you were ashamed of him.
I'm not ashamed of him.
Is he in the building trade?
No.
That's a pity. Son's looking for a carpenter. Yeah, pity your old man's not in the building game.
Yeah.
And most of the carpenters I know are in the building game. Does he make furniture?
No, not exactly.
That's a pity. My daughter's husband's looking for someone to knock up a few cupboards for him. Yes, and they need him too. 5 kids in 7 years. Not the bastard's a mick. Now, she's not, but he's pretty strict. Ought to be needing the balls. So what if he's got to face the priest? Now, she's the one who's got to have him. I can't stand micks. You a mick?
No. No.
My wife's a mick. It's not her fault, and I respect her point of view. Mm. Yeah, they're taking over the force, you know. Salmon sandwiches on Friday if you want to get to be Sergeant Ross. I told my daughter not to marry the bastard, but she couldn't afford to be choosy. No, she's not bad looking, mind you, and a good ass. But she's an irritable bitch. Her mother all over again. Yeah. Pity your old man doesn't make furniture.
Yes.
Well, if he doesn't make houses and he doesn't make furniture, then what in the hell does he make?
What? Why did you want to know?
Is he the one that gave you this thing of yours about money?
I haven't got a thing about money.
Then why were you carrying on about the pay?
I wasn't carrying on about the pay. I just said that you've got to consider it.
There, you see that?
Yeah.
What is it?
Money.
Yep. Where did it come from?
I don't know.
Look, I can walk out of this station tonight, grab myself a cray and half a dozen tubes, get home, sit myself down in front of the box and watch the wrestling. Do you know where it came from?
No.
From my pay packet. That's where it came from. No payoffs, no nothing. From my pay packet. Now, do you know why I'm never short of a dollar, Ross?
No.
Because I've never been stupid enough to mortgage myself up to the hilt. Bought myself a little weatherboard in Box Hill 19 years ago. Do you know what my repayments are?
No.
$5 a week. Don't chase your ass, boy, you get me? There's a lot more to be got out of life than chasing your ass. Yeah. It's a good life for you here in the force. If you know how to organise yourself.
It's a pretty good life, is it?
If you know how to organise yourself and get your priorities straight. Now, stuff the rule book up your ass. That's the first thing you got to learn. You get me? Life's got its own rules.
Suppose this is a pretty busy station, huh?
Well, it could be. If you let it be.
How do you mean?
Just what I said. Oh, this district's got the highest incidence of crime in the metropolitan area. All your underworld is within a 2-mile radius of this station. Tough as nails around here, mate. I'd hate to think of the number of stiffs lying in shallow graves in the Dandenongs courtesy of this district, boy.
Really?
Yep, I reckon this would be about your city's geographical centre of crime. Now, that is why they opened up this sub-branch. To help the main station. Mm. And we do. But there's only two of us here, right? Mm. And we can't handle anything big. Do you get me? Mm. You get me?
Mm.
We can't handle anything big because there's only two of us. Now, we can handle anything small, but then again, it's hardly worth the effort if it's small. The workload around here is very much a matter of how we see things, Ross. Something doesn't have to be very big before it's too big for us. And likewise, something doesn't have to be all that small before it's not worth worrying about. Oh, this is the best posting in the city, boy. You think yourself lucky.
What do we do then?
Anything that looks interesting. And if there's nothing interesting, we watch the midday movie. There's an old Errol Flynn on today. Do you like Errol Flynn?
How often do you get something that looks interesting?
Depends what sort of mood you're in. Yeah, some days just about anything's interesting. I thought perhaps your arrival might have been interesting.
Oh. I'm sorry.
Just joking, Ross. Just joking. Yeah. Got one boy posted out here who walked in and said, "I've heard about you, you great fat heap of shit." That was interesting.
Why'd you say that?
I hope you're not a young smart ass, Ross. Because there's no room for that here. There's one person in authority here, and that's me. Do you understand, Ross?
Yes.
Let's get that straight right at the outset. What's your father do?
I don't think it's any of your business.
I thought we just had this out. Who's in authority here?
I just don't think that it's any of your business.
Look, Ross, I'm an authority here and I'll decide what's my business and what isn't my business. You're a bit of a rebel in your own quiet way, aren't you? Makes you feel good?
No.
Doesn't make you feel good?
No.
What? You just like being a rebel for the sake of being a rebel?
No, no.
Oh, I hope you're not going to turn out to be a smart ass, Ross. You'll go for a row of shit cans if you try anything smart with me, boy.
I just didn't think it was any of your business what my father does.
How long have you been in the force, boy?
Are you?
Not in training, in the force, in it.
This is my first post.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.